Well, thank you so much for helping my project. Could you tell me a little bit about yourself?
Okay, so my name is Adeniro Adeyemi. I'm a Nigerian, and I'm currently enrolled in a master's degree program at the University of Ibadan here in Nigeria. Career-wise, I work with an agricultural consulting firm where I occupy the position of a team lead, a research team lead. So my daily routine looks like when I wake up in the morning. I work remotely, so I manage a team of about 7 people. I work remotely, and there are times when I also have to visit client facilities. Basically, we work with agricultural organizations providing private extension to them. So most of what we do revolves around capacity development for food production, training activities. We also engage in consulting services. We consult for government, for private individuals, for international non-governmental organizations, and any interested company that requires our services. And also, personal level, I'm single. I'm from a family of 6 people. My parents are late though, but I have 4 siblings. 3 of them stay in Nigeria, while one lives in the United States of America. And yeah, so while I was growing up, space is something that used to fascinate me a lot. As a young person, I'm always fascinated by space. In fact, I love space movies. One of my favorite movies of all time would be Armageddon. I don't know if you have seen that movie, Armageddon. I think it's directed by, I can't remember the director now, a very popular director, Mel Gibson. Mel Gibson. Armageddon by Mel Gibson. And that movie, I think they went to the moon on that movie. They wanted to, there was this object, a space object that was causing a lot of, it was erupting in space. And every time it erupts in space, it causes explosions on Earth. And at a point, there was going to be a total eruption, and that would have wiped all of Earth. So Mel Gibson, a team of scientists from Earth had to go to space, to detonate it. And so that really spurred my interest in space exploration and all of that. And I was constantly fascinated by space and everything. And recently, when Richard Branson and Elon Musk, when they traveled to space, I followed it, and I felt the enthusiasm. I was very enthusiastic, and I really love that humans are conquering everywhere, ocean, space, and all of that. So when I saw this opportunity, I felt, oh, this is something I want to be part of, and I've been looking forward to have this interview with you. So that's basically about me.
I have to look up that movie. I thought I saw all of Mel Gibson's movies. I
Oh,
can't believe he had a movie about space that I missed. So I'm gonna have to do some
yes,
research.
I'm a ghetto. Yes, you should. If you watch that movie, it's
Armageddon.
very interesting.
How do you
I'm a
spell it?
ghetto. I'm a ghetto. I'm a ghetto. I'll type it in the chat box.
Oh, awesome. Awesome. So,
Yeah.
did you know that NASA is planning to send astronauts to the moon in 2024 for the first time since 1972?
Yes. I read the write-up on your email, and that really brought me up to speed on that information. I didn't know prior to your mail, but when I got your mail, it was part of the information that came with your mail. So now I know, even though I don't have much information about everything they are trying to do, but I know that bit of information that they are trying to send people to space. But let me ask, are these normal, regular people or scientists that they are trying to put on the moon?
Well, they're trained astronauts, so they've applied to become NASA astronauts or an astronaut by for like the Canadian Space Agency or the European Space Agency, and they've been training for years. Most of them have some type of engineering or science degree. So not like regular everyday people in the sense of, you know, it's a highly selective, competitive group, so. Are you still there? Can you hear me? It looks like you're frozen. Oh, you're back. It looks like you're on mute. I think it kicked you out and put you back in.
Okay, yeah, so I lost your feed for some few seconds there.
Yeah, I had the same trouble too.
Okay.
So what do you think about us going back to the moon?
So yes, I think it's high time we do that, considering that the last time was more than 30 years ago. I'm sure going there now, there will be a lot of information, there will be a lot of new discoveries, and thankfully that we have better facilities now. We have gadgets that are sophisticated. There are going to be a lot of new awesome discoveries that we can make now. You know, depending on because of the advancement in technology that has occurred between that time and now. So yeah, it's the right time to do that. And I look forward to all the cool discoveries. Probably. We know more about our planetary systems, we know more about the moon, we know more about gravitational forces this time around that we are. In fact, I didn't know that it has been that long since the last time anybody went to the moon. I didn't know until this conversation. I thought it was something that, I know a lot of time astronauts go into space, you know. So I felt that has been occurring, that that has been a normal thing. I didn't know that it has been that long since somebody actually landed on the moon. So 2024, it's a good time. It's high time that we do that. And hopefully, scientists are also able to explore other planets in more details. So yes, it's a welcome development, one which I believe everyone is looking forward to. To know what can we find out this time around. You know, we are looking forward to answers. We are looking forward to discoveries. You know, we are looking forward to awesome explorations and new facts that will emerge from that trip.
I'm definitely looking forward to it too. And it's so close too. You know, it's only a few years away. If it was safe and affordable, would you go to space?
What can you repeat that?
Yes, if it was safe and affordable, would you go to space?
Of course, especially if it's being sponsored. Yes, if it's affordable, I would love to, even though at this time it's out of reach to non-billionaires. I think it's only billionaires that can do that for now. But if it becomes affordable, why not? I believe with time, maybe in the next 50 years, that should be a thing that is, you know, the same way people go to the Maldives, the same way people go for vacation, you know, in exotic places around the world. I think space should be the next big thing when it comes to vacationing and adventure. Hopefully, it will become affordable during our own generation. Hopefully, you know. Yes, but if it's affordable, something I'd love to do. I totally love to.
Well, that's awesome. And I'm really feeling like that over the next, 10 years or so, more and more people will have the opportunity. I hope you get that opportunity too. Well,
yeah,
And those are pretty much the questions I had. Was there something you wanted to add, or did you have any questions for me?
Okay, so my questions for you. I'm yet to really understand your involvement in all of this. I know it's for a research, but what's going to be the outcome of the research? And if you don't mind, can you tell me something about you?
Absolutely. So I work for a software company, and I work in their support group. Space is a big hobby of mine. So there's a number of things that I do to explore that hobby. I go to like space events. Like my son and my wife and I, we went to Guadalajara to watch Elon Musk talk about the interplanetary transportation system. We went to Brownsville to see the Starship that's being developed. Also, I have a group I put together, the North Houston Space Society. And then I'm doing this daily interview project to kind of put together a time capsule of how people think about the future and about space right before we take those next steps on the moon.
Wow, that's awesome. That's awesome. That's awesome. And let me see. Let me thank you for your so far, because I know every day people need to take. We need to also take. We need to take actions that will complement what the scientists are doing. Even though we are not scientists, but mere talking about it, mere talking about spreading information about it is helping a lot. Because now I didn't know this before. Now I know, and because of that, I can also engage other people in these conversations. And the more people know, the better, because then we can have these conversations that can change, that can bring about favorable policies, favorable outcomes. Perhaps we can get to a point where we start pushing for advocacy to commercialize travel to space. Anything can happen. So I will say well done, and I will say thank you for your efforts, and it's been wonderful speaking to you this afternoon, and I hope we keep in touch somehow. I don't know if that's a possibility, but I do hope we keep in touch, and we keep having this conversation as things evolve.
Yeah, absolutely. I'd love to stay in touch. We got email, Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter. So many choices.
That's true. So any more questions for me?
Not for now. You have a good class, and I hope you have a good rest of your day also.
Thank you. I will. All right. My regards to your club guys and to everyone around you. Have a nice day.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
All right. Bye-bye.